Buenos días. Quiero comenzar dándole la bienvenida a todos los funcionarios de gobierno y representantes del sector privado que participan en este seminario. Y quiero agradecer
muy especialmente a Marta Lucía Ramírez, the Vice President of Colombia, and our distinguished panelists who are with us today. Investing in women is investing in society. Throughout my career, I have seen the transformational effect of closing gaps that disproportionately affect business women, and I have witnessed the power of the network of mutual support. When I previously worked at Citibank, it was my privilege to integrate and promote the creation of mentoring programs and create networks of contacts for women in Latin America and Asia. It is an honor for me to be here with you today and to offer up a few initial reflections for this meeting, which will touch on a topic that is a strategic priority for the bank and extremely dear to me, strengthening micro, small, and medium-sized businesses, MSMEs, that are women-led or women-owned. This represents the intersection of three priority areas for the bank for economic recovery and job creation in the region. One, the economic empowerment of women. Two, digitization, and finally, integrating women in value chains. In Latin America and the Caribbean, there are over 27 million MSMEs. Of these, 95% are micro businesses, and they generate 61% of jobs. MSMEs are the engine of the economy in our region, and these make up 99% of all total businesses. We know that the effects of the pandemic have been devastating. In 2020, our region saw a slowdown to the tune of 7.4% of the GDP. The COVID-19 Work Observatory of the IDB Group shows a loss of at least 30 million jobs. And ECLAC calculates that the percentage of MSMEs that are in danger of closing could be over 20%. The outlook for MSMEs that are managed by women is even more complex. Their involvement in global value chains is limited. Their level of use and adopting information and communication technology is low. It is more possible that their businesses will close and their access to financing is insufficient. The financing gap in our region actually is over $91 billion, which is the highest in the world. Today is a part of the IDB Group's commitment to growth and making women-owned or women-led MSMEs visible. I am pleased to announce the launch of the Women Growing Together in the Americas program in order to help these businesses continue to be the engines of economic recovery and to create jobs in Latin America and the Caribbean. This program will provide technical assistance that is focused, first of all, on strengthening capacities and improving production in order to make it easier for these businesses to become a part of foreign trade and value chains when it comes to the use and adoption of technologies for transformation and for optimizing business processes. And it will focus on improving financial management of businesses in order to facilitate access to financing. Additionally, this program will provide mentorship by experts in these issues. It will be joined by Connect Americas, the initiative at the IDB. Currently, there are over 125,000 businesswomen who are a part of it, and this will have a multiplying effect in the entire region. This program also is a complement to other initiatives that the IDB works on, led by IDB Lab, the social sector, and IDB Invest, our private branch. And as the name would indicate, Growing Together in the Americas means that we need a collective effort. That is why I would like to sincerely thank the partners of our program who are with us today, helping business women grow their businesses and help grow their communities and economies via job creation. Finally, though, I would like to thank all of you, business women. I would like to thank you for your strength and your tenacity. This program is for and by all of you. I invite you to make the most of it. Go to connectamericas.com.
Pleca Mujeres.